AquarianRadio.com.
Aloha, this is Enki. You know me as Aquarius, and this is our age, the Satayuga. Time to celebrate with us. We have programs on all chakra tantra, love styles and relationship choices, counseling strategies and techniques that you can use at home. We have extraterrestrial radio, where we deal with alienology, paranormal people, and we have an experiencers network. We have a section called Ancient Aliens, and the programs therein are Enki Speaks, Nimma, the Mother of Humanity, has her program, and we revise ancient anthropology. And most important of all, we have peace paradigms. Because this is the age of peace, harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding. No more falsehoods or derisions, golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelations, and the mind's true liberation.
I'm Nimma, an extraterrestrial from the planet Nibiru, mother goddess and creator of humanity. I came here 400,000 years ago. I designed human hybrids, blended the right combination of Homo erectus and the genes of my Anunnaki brother Enki, which I mixed in a clay vessel of the earth. I carried this fetus in my womb, gave birth to the first human being. You all carry my mitochondrial DNA. You are all my children. I love you. I have messages for you to civilize your civilization, create a partnership society, balance masculine and feminine, and bring you forth into this golden age of Aquarius.
Aliens rule this world, and they've been in charge all along. They govern us from the top of the all-seeing eye of the pyramid down to the clerks at the county courthouse who dictate to us every nuance of how to live our lives. We are not free, nor have we ever been. We're taxed up to our eyeballs. This money fuels this evil, Illuminati, corrupt, corporate, governmental, political, religious system. Religions, politics, and corporations all are instruments of the Anunnaki aliens who use these systems to subdivide and separate us. Divided, we are conquered, controlled, slaves. Anyone who believes in hierarchy and acts from it feels superior or better, looks down their noses at another person, participates in prejudice, racism, or judgment, is participating in their mass mind control, psychological manipulation that creates the matrix that binds us in eternal slavery. This is hell. Hell on earth, a system created to keep us separate from one another, distance from love. Love, which is our natural state. We are loving oneness. Yet, this system disconnects us from one another, separates us, and keeps us from truth and authentic, unconditional love. We hardly know love, for we don't know who we are, because we are so mind-controlled and manipulated by the system, the Anunnaki alien system. We are chemtrailed and GMO'd. There are chemicals in our land, water, air, which slowly kill us, starting in the womb, before we're even born. We're mind-controlled by our media, all media written and transmitted through waves blasted through the air, which run through us, continually short-circuiting our systems and contributing to disease. Illness, death, disease, and corruption runs rampant within ourselves and throughout the entire system. What a system! Where is God in all this anyway? Is there even such a thing as God? God is an idea, a concept hijacked by the evil Illuminati, extraterrestrial, alien, Anunnaki who started this all. They are still here. they still rule our world. So what can we do? We, the puppet people, the sheeple, who are manipulated daily from top to bottom, are in deep kimchi. They employ us, so we participate fully, afraid to lose our jobs, homes, family, freedom, our lives, our simple little lives that mean so much to us and so little to them. Where is the love? Do they feel love? Somehow we're all connected. This is a system which we're in and participate in. No victims, really. How's that, you say? They are us and we are they. Realize, on the highest of high levels, there are no victims. We generated this passion play, this reality game from the fabric of time and space itself, symbolized in the movie called The Matrix. Yes, this is a game. And we are the game masters, the maker, and every character in this movie, including the director. We created divine play, which is called Leela. And if we wake up, figure it out, for that's really what this game is all about. Being in the maze, the matrix, the labyrinth of life, and figuring it out. First, you discover that you're in the illusion. You're trapped in here by your own doing, and that if you're smart enough, you can figure it out and then find a way out. The clock is ticking. You realize you created time, a concept to add to the drama. It's 11:59, almost midnight. Time's running out. You have 60 seconds. If you don't do it while you're alive, you're dead. And you come back as a baby, totally unconscious and helpless, and have to figure it all out again. You do it again and again and again. This is hell. There's nowhere to go when you're already in it. And next time around, the programming's even heavier because it's Groundhog Day. Another round, and the Illuminati have tightened the screws. You're screwed, we're screwed, because technology's advanced in their favor, yet another degree, and this another degree, and this time, we're microchipped from birth. These implants control our minds, our every thought, ideas, movement. We're robotized. We think we're humans, but we're android super soldiers in the war, the battle, and we think this is life. We believe so this is it is. We believe so, so it is. And here, we're here to find love in all this. But each generation's further down the hole. What can we do? How do we get out of this mess? We are God's source, manifest in human form. We are consciousness, embodied in physical beings. We've done this before. We exist here, there, everywhere, including the highest of high levels of consciousness. There's a part of us out there, enlightened, attached to the Creator and all there is, was, and ever will be. We know, on some level, we created this in the first place. We are the Creator. Wake up! The big catch-22 of this system, which is a system within systems, is when we resolve all these things and these issues and wake up, when we are finally outside of the game, then what do we do? Obviously, we created this all in the first place to facilitate creation, creativity, and maximize diversity. Problem-solving, drama, and conflict create resolutions, outcomes, and things. But it's painful, hurtful, feels horrible, so why do it? Why? Well, perhaps we were bored. Since all is an illusion, there's really no birth, life, death, time, time loop, matrix. It's just a computer game, a virtual reality. If this one ends, we'll probably just create another game to act out this which we call life. Otherwise, what is there? Earth is an experiment in consciousness, the lowest dimension, third dimensional physicality. This is the densest vibratory frequency there is. Get it? We're dense. We don't feel each other because we're in skin-encapsulated self-senses, desensitized in the first place so we can believe there's self and not self. Otherwise, how could we possibly do these heinous things to ourselves? Yes, there are those who actually kill themselves through suicide, but most can't bring themselves to do that. And murdering another, well, that's done all the time. Sometimes we humans justify murder and call it war. We call it self-defense. Somehow we hope to feel better about the act. But killing's killing, and while many can and have killed, there are those too civilized to contemplate it themselves. But even then, most kill something. When it comes down to it, and a mosquito's biting, well, we swat it and kill it. And yes, there are some, like perhaps the Dalai Lama, who restrain from killing even when being bit. But most are not that conscious and kill on some level. It's human nature, after all. And that's also a lame excuse. Consciousness is, as long as we exist, and we will exist, for we are here now existing. You are here reading this story. We are. We be. We are human beings. So, for as long as we are consciousness, who have agreed to go unconscious, to participate in this game. The Earth virtual reality game, so we can experience this thing we call life and have experiences. And if we're lucky within the game, we'll find love, experience love, enjoy it, and have fun now and then, now and again. Get some laughs along the way. Love is truly the way out of this. Love is our greatest weapon against war. If you love someone, truly love them, you'll never, ever harm them. Answer is, love everyone. So I'll finish this rant with a short story. I had a lucid dream, the kind where you're aware you're dreaming. And this was in the late 1980s. I think it was 1989, and I just moved to State College, Pennsylvania with my second husband. In the dream, there was a great flood and earthquakes descending on the world. I came into the dream witnessing it all from above. As I zoomed into my body, I first saw that I was carrying two cats in cat carriers. I was running uphill as fast as I could with a backpack on my back and carrying two cats. So, think about it. I was probably toting at least 40 or 50 pounds and running uphill. That in itself is a feat, and I don't believe I could do that as I have lung disease. So I knew it was a virtual reality dream right off the bat. And if it was true, then I must have had so much adrenaline pumping that I was Superwoman herself. At that point began a communication from God. There I was running and in full communication with someone with greater awareness than I, who was instructing me to get to high ground, the top of the mountain, and there I would be beamed up on board the ship and taken to safety. God has a ship. Good. I always knew that on some level and had no doubt. God would take me elsewhere in his spaceship. Cool. I stopped right there mid-stride in my tracks and said, "But wait, what about the others?" God replied, "Don't worry. Everyone you love will be transported to safety along with you." I still didn't move, but pondered the situation. Somehow I knew this was the future, for in that now, back then and there, I lay sleeping in my bed in Pennsylvania. This was 1989. This was the future conveyed to me, not by words, but by impressions, concepts, ideas. No words, thoughts. Thoughts which are more accurate and valid than actual words. Words, language, written and oral, are subparsing from whole concepts, and thus contain programming in every vowel and syllable, are corrupt in that fashion, much like a computer with a virus. I knew I was in a dream. A game within this game of life. Like putting a VHS on hold while you get a drink or take a bathroom break. This movie still ran while I contemplated all the implications. I thought, and it was on pause, and while the movie's still there, on pause, there's certainly a lot of static going on, and things are as clear as mud. So here I was, observer, witness, being given a glimpse of the wizard behind the curtain, and I froze time. I paused, contemplated, breathed, realized, and with that realization, knew that I was in control. Voila! I had the upper hand and could break this game down to the core of its very existence. so I responded telepathically to God. Then, by the time this day comes, I will love everyone in this planet unconditionally. If I love all unconditionally, totally, you'll have to take all of us, every man, woman, child. You must take every animal, plant, bug, every creature, feature, mountain, valley, ocean, sky, this whole world, the earth. By the time this day comes, I will love it all. And you just said, you promised that all I love will be saved. So you must, by your own agreement, stop this destruction as you can, because you are God, and save us all. From not only this day, but for all time, for eternity, and never, ever threaten to destroy us ever again. Agreed, said God, and so it is. Love all completely, totally, unconditionally, and all make it. For all who have been created, all souls, are like pieces in a giant puzzle. Each play their part, are equally important, essential. Each fit into one another, a puzzle complete. Only if all pieces are found, put together, united, connected. And if one piece of the puzzle is missing, that hole draws the eye to it, and you can't really see anything else but the hole. That is existence, the universe. We are one giant puzzle, and the whole is only complete with all of us in it. We truly are one.
Thanks for joining us today on Aquarian Radio. We broadcast daily, and our schedule is on aquarianradio.com. Listen live by calling 646-649-0893, or you can listen live by calling 646-649-0893. Or listen to our archives on AquarianRadio.com. Join us again soon, and do tell your friends, the age of Aquarius and the paradigm of peace is now.
Aloha, this is Enki. You know me as Aquarius, and this is our age, the Satayuga. Time to celebrate with us. We have programs on all chakra tantra, love styles and relationship choices, counseling strategies and techniques that you can use at home. We have extraterrestrial radio, where we deal with alienology, paranormal people, and we have an experiencers network. We have a section called Ancient Aliens, and the programs therein are Enki Speaks, Nimma, the Mother of Humanity, has her program, and we revise ancient anthropology. And most important of all, we have peace paradigms, because this is the age of peace. Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding, no more falsehoods or derisions, golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelations, and the mind's true liberation.
And this has been another episode here at AquarianRadio.com.
AquarianRadio.com.
Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding.